hip, called on the phone and he spoke to me in excited tones. He said, word, snap, give me five, yo, what up? It was his usual jive. He was excited as all get out. He started to scream, he commenced to shout about how if I was all alone, he'd be right over and we'd get gone to a place he'd heard about where the girls were sure to knock me out. He said it was a swinging place, the atmosphere was real fast paced, drinks were good, band was great, all the women had a sexy face, they outnumbered the guys by 3 to 1, if I couldn't pick one up, I was either deaf or dumb. He said get ready as I could get, and he'd be right over in his red Corvette. So I hung up the phone, dashed upstairs, I took a shower and I washed my ears. As I sprinkled some dozen eggs on my feet, I gargled good and I brushed my teeth. I got my antiperspirant that never fails. I washed my socks and I clipped my nails. And then I scrubbed my hair with a new shampoo, ran my hair blower through and through. I sprayed it over with some of that gook so as to give it a natural look. It was an environmentally safe product of an herbal nature. Did not harm the ozone layer and no animals were harmed in its manufacture, and it left my hair soft and natural. Well, I went and I got my very best Versace shirt and a matching vest. If that still hasn't got you impressed, I left it unbuttoned to show my hairy chest. And then around my neck on a chain so fine, I hung a 10-pound medallion with my zodiac sign. I got my two-tone platform, my Italian shoes, but I still didn't know which pants to choose. Well, I had to have something to make them scream. Pick my distressed designer jeans. Couldn't find anything else to wear, so I went and I stood by my full-length mirror, and for the next hour and 15 minutes I looked at my reflection in it. I was practicing body language. My friend showed up in his brand new car. Away we went to check out the bar he'd been talking and yelling about. Yes, sir, we were gonna check it out. Well, we got inside, I could hardly see. There was people everywhere stepping on my feet. Music blaring, you couldn't speak. You had to shout your words through your teeth. All this fun just waiting for me. Besides all that, the pretzels were free. But the funniest thing that I did see is everybody there looked just like me. Yes, everybody looks goddamn neat, like a room full of peacocks and peahens and heat. Faces searching over tables and chairs for others not quite as beautiful as theirs. There was teenage sex queens with faces congealed, machismo fury and elevator heels. Made me think of a sparkler lost its fire. Made me think of... Oh, what's her name? I'll never forget her. Well, the atmosphere got a little stale. I went over and I ordered a Molson's Ale. I hopped on a table, took off my clothes. I jumped out the window and ran down the road. See, I'd rather be arrested and thrown in the hold for being indecently exposed than trying to strike with silly pose in my just bought boutique clothes. Anyhow, I got a crooked nose.